Coming up, we look at Azure Security Center, a new service that helps you tap into Microsoft's real-time intelligence on the threat landscape, including how it can help you get centralized security monitoring, set policy and deploy security controls for your Azure resources, and get advanced threat detection with machine learning. I'm joined by Product Manager Ryan McGee. Welcome.
Thank you.
So from an IT and information security perspective, what are we trying to solve for?
Well, you know, if your organization has a lot of resources deployed in Azure, you probably have a list that looks like mine here, but a little bit longer. Mm-hmm. And if you're not the operational owner of all of those resources, it can be difficult to get the visibility you need into the security state of them. And if you're the security administrator, well, you're definitely going to be accountable for the security state of all these resources. And so first and foremost, Azure Security Center is here to help give you that visibility. Now, I have it pinned here to my start board, but you can actually open it up for the first time by hitting the browse button here. And then if you just start typing security,
okay,
you can get into it here. And you'll see immediately this centralized view of all the security health of your resources across all your Azure subscriptions. But the first thing you want to do when you come into it is turn on information collection.
Okay, so I see that you have that one turned on already. Now, I'm assuming it's not on by default, though.
That's right, yeah. Okay. You make the decision to turn this on, and when you do, we start collecting a bunch of information from the configuration and behavior of the virtual machines, Windows and Linux, in mm-hmm. your subscriptions, in addition to the things we already know about your networking and your other types of resources, databases, and applications.
So if you're a security administrator and your organization has deployed some resources to the cloud, you're going to want to define some policies for how these resources get protected against attack and how data is secured.
Yeah, so you see these policies here are going to drive what recommendations I'm going to get. So I can set all kinds of policies for systems, for mm-hmm. networks, for applications, and so forth.
What about different types of resources? What if you have some resources that are for dev and test and also ones for production? You don't want to have the same policies going across both of those.
Right. So we do separate these policies by subscription. So I can set one policy for my production resources. Maybe that was my pay-as-you-go subscription that we just looked at. Mm-hmm. And then I could have a different policy if all my development and test resources were here in this Visual Studio subscription. I could set a different policy here. Now, once you've set all of those, you can go back and you're ready to look at resource security health. So this is pulling from all those policies and giving you some recommendations based on the policy you've set.
Okay.
So I'm going to see here, like, do I have all my virtual machines updated? Do they have the right baseline rules configured? Are they running malware, anti-malware, I should say? I can see whether my databases are encrypted and auditable. Mm-hmm. I can look at my web applications, make sure they have web app firewalls in front of them. Or let's look at networking specifically. I can see here that I have some network interfaces that don't have network security groups enabled, or I also have a few endpoints without access control lists. So mm-hmm. these are the types of recommendations that I get. And on any one of them, I could drill in and get some more information. We also collect them all in one spot here in this recommendations tile for easy access.
Oh, okay.
So now let's look at this one. For example, I have one that says I have a web application that is not protected by a web application firewall. And as I look at that, it's going to give me a recommendation about what to do about it.
Mm-hmm. I'm assuming this is where you're going to click on one of those, it's going to take you out to the marketplace to have to go off and purchase it and get it all configured.
No, actually, it's going to take me right through the process right here in context. So I can click on this, and it'll walk me through the installation process. It also does a bunch of the configuration for me. And once that thing is installed, that partner solution will start feeding data back into Azure Security Center, so that's even feeding more into the central security view of your Azure resources.
Okay. So now that you have all these right controls and policies in place across your different subscriptions and vulnerabilities, attackers are still going to be innovating with different ways that they're going to be able to try to go in and attack your accounts. How do we take account for all those different types of threats?
Well, this is where Microsoft Intelligence kicks in. So we actually have a bunch of security alerts down here where we're going to start to notify you about things that you might not otherwise catch okay. by virtue of having a huge presence on the internet mm-hmm. and watching everything that goes on other Azure subscribers' deployments. We can learn a lot about the global landscape of threats. And so those alerts show up here. And you can see, for example, I have one at the top here that says RDP brute force attempt, right? So maybe I'm protected, but I want to know about the fact that somebody's trying to get into this machine. And what we're doing here is we're actually applying advanced analysis and machine learning to all of that global threat intelligence that we've gathered so that we can know what is abnormal for this machine. Mm-hmm. You know, not just in the global sense, but what's an abnormal amount of RDP traffic for that particular machine. So that's one type of alert. You'll also get alerts about behavioral analysis on virtual machines, abnormal network communications, and communication with known malicious IPs on the internet. We know about those because of our global threat intelligence as mm-hmm. well.
So we've seen standardized policies, we've seen alerts, and how you can stay protected across multiple different types of subscriptions. So I know Saatchi has been talking a lot about security intelligence. This goes way beyond simple VM policies. How does this fit into the overall big picture?
Well, this is one great example of the direction that Microsoft is taking security. Mm-hmm. We're really working on building that intelligence and continuing to build it. And so as we continue to collect and analyze security signals across Azure and from our other products, devices and applications, you'll see even more automated detection of new threats and vulnerabilities added to Security Center without you having to turn anything new on.
Okay. I'm bought in. How do I go ahead and get started, man?
Well, it's really easy. You just start it up the way that we showed earlier. Mm-hmm. It's available in preview now for every Azure subscriber.
Is it free to go off and use this right now?
For the most part, yes. We looked at policy setting, resource security health recommendations. That's all free with every Azure subscription. There's a couple of costs to be aware of. One is when we turn on information collection, as we did in that first step, we have to store that information somewhere, and so there's a slight cost you'll incur in terms mm-hmm. of storage.
Yeah.
And the other is when we do all of that machine learning and advanced analytics to give you those security alerts that continue to advance and grow over time, there's an additional fee per resource associated with that capability.
Hopefully, this will help you protect your resources in Azure. Keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest updates. Bye for now.